So, we're back with another Bleach video, and this is about the infamous question of who is going to animate Bleach. Now, of course, this has stemmed from a singular tweet being from Studio Pierrot themselves, and it is quite interesting. I'm not going to say he is, and I'm not going to say he isn't, because obviously I would rather prefer a absolute official confirmation. However, this does seem to break a little bit of its marketing code, and this is why it is so interesting. And I imagine a lot of people on social media are going to be talking about this specific tweet as a whole. So I do think it is relevant that I do give my two cents on this. Now, of course, the tweet of which we are speaking of here is on screen. As you can see, it is a Bleach basically having a collaboration with a women's fashion design clothing, as far as I'm aware. They might do men's stuff as well, I'm not quite sure. But either or, this was in the latest Weekly Shonen Jump promotion. And for the first time, Pierrot are promoting Bleach that isn't something of their asset. And what I mean by this is that, yes, Pierrot have promoted Bleach in the past year, but that doesn't really confirm anything, because they were promoting past episodes, reruns of episodes, things that they owned and did, things such as like on Amazon Prime or Netflix, or again TV studios that I cannot name, but it's in my head. We also have things such as the BBS promotions too, which of course they would promote as well, because they are also a stakeholder and they are also on the production committee of the Bleach Brave Souls team as well. And they have also promoted before collaborations, but of course these are within their own assets that they have created previously. So this is for the first time that they have promoted Bleach that really has nothing to do with them. And it is also the first time that they've used the hashtag acknowledging the 20th anniversary of Bleach by using the hashtags Bleach Animation and Bleach 20th anniversary. So why is that such a big thing? Because for once they are promoting something that doesn't entirely benefit them. So why would they do this if they didn't want to push their own IP, especially one that is possibly renewed? From my interpretation, the fact that they are acknowledging the 20th anniversary, it seems a bit alienated that a company or a studio would acknowledge a 20th anniversary as well as use the hashtag Bleach Animation if another studio was to have it. Why would you promote someone else's goods in the future if you aren't going to be promoting it in the future yourself? So realistically, this is the only information we have to go off on right now. And I always expected that it was Pierrot. Yes, we had some rumors about Madhouse, and there is no shadow of doubt in my mind that Bleach will be outsourced to other studios such as Madhouse, just like studios before when they did some episodes, especially on the filler, be it the studio itself or even animators from Shaft themselves coming over to Pierrot. We don't know really the context behind that rumor or that leak, but that's why I'm kind of holding my breath on that as a whole. Now, of course, people, if this is true and it is Pierrot, it's also probably going to worry a lot of people too. Of course, when Black Clover was coming to its end, people were saying obviously the animators are going to go over to Bleach. Now, bear in mind that the production of Bleach had started quite a while ago while people were working on Black Clover, so the chances that you're going to have people go from Black Clover over to Bleach is very unlikely, especially whatever the announcement is for Black Clover. You know, who knows, it might have a movie, it might have a special OVA, it might, who knows. But if that is the case, that there is going to be more animation for Black Clover, then of course those animators would also work on that project too. So, as I said, the production started before Black Clover was ending anyway. So, and that kind of goes into Abe too, the previous anime director for Bleach. He has been working on Boruto as well. Now, of course, we know that Yoshihara, who worked on Black Clover, has been going on to Jujutsu Kaisen, but that was a good few months prior. So there is a bit of a time lag in regards to that. So Abe could potentially be working on Bleach, but the chances are, I don't see the time difference being that valuable for me to say if he is or isn't. So it is going to be interesting if we do get a new director, and I'm more so leaning on the case that they will. But again, Abe could just come through and do some Bleach goodness. But he seems pretty focused on assisting with Boruto at the moment, so it is a little bit sketch. Of course, Pierrot doesn't have, as of now, the best reputation as it is. I mean, for example, Boruto, right? The only in-house thing that's really going on with Boruto is its orchestra or its sound mixing, right? Or its composer, I would say. And they only really have one. So Pierrot really aren't what they used to be. However, they have worked on a recent series, as I've done in a video before, called Akudama Drive, which did look very good. And that took, I believe, a few years to make. So I do have somewhat a bit of faith in Pierrot, especially with the time that we had the announcement back in last Anime Japan. It's almost been a year now, very close to a year. So of course we've had at least a good amount of pre-production and a good amount of production, and we also know that it's probably not going to be coming out for another while yet. So add a few months, maximum another year into the equation, and we've got more than enough time going into it. So I'm not entirely worried at the moment, and the fact that it has been extremely case closed quiet with how things haven't leaked with the Bleach production, I think is a very good sign in and of itself. Especially, it tells me that there's not going to be a lot of Westerners working on it, because generally speaking, in the leaking world, Westerners or foreigners are usually the ones to leak it more so than the Japanese. So that's how I've kind of come to that overall conclusion. So overall, what does this tweet say? It's interesting. A studio has acknowledged the 20th anniversary of Bleach. They've acknowledged the Bleach animation. And to me, it tells me that a studio or a company would not promote a product if it was within someone else's hands. So chances are the main studio, and I use that as a quotation, the main studio will be Perrier. But that doesn't mean that other collaborations with other studios can't happen as well. But again, we need the context to that leak slash rumor or that possibility. And this could also be a good opportunity for Perrier to make a name for themselves, because of course Netflix are obviously hiring a lot of studios based on their reputation as well as of recently too. So of course I think Perrier are going to want to get some value on their name again, like they did back in the day. So it is just a quick video of my thoughts. Do I think Perrier have got it? I thought it a long time ago. It would be easiest because they've got assets from a long time ago that they can reuse, whether that's in flashbacks, whether that's reanimation, whether that's connections to animators and directors. So I also believe they're a big enough studio to have the facilities to do Bleach as well. I do believe, and I always did believe, that Perrier had some sort of influence within Bleach's new animation. Now, of course, people are saying, well, what about Aniplex? Well, Aniplex were always involved with Bleach. They were realistically part of the rights for the music, and they were, because they were distributing the CDs for the music and also distributing the DVDs. Now, of course, with this whole thing with Aniplex that has been obviously floating around for quite a while, it could just mean that they have a bigger stakehold within the production committee, so they can fund more money into it. They have a bigger influence within, maybe within the merchandising game, or whether the CD game, the DVD game, you know, they have more of an influence in terms of like marketing possibly. So the Aniplex thing really kind of still adds up to that degree. So it just depends on the context. So I'm really excited to see how this all unfolds so we can start putting the puzzle pieces together. So there's the tweet. You know, it is a bit of a stretch, I think, because there is no official confirmation. However, I think the logic behind the tweet and the speculation is kind of, it's validated in its own sense and right. So again, it's a bit of a weird tweet to promote, out of all things to promote, like a clothing collaboration. It is a bit weird. However, I'm very interested to see what Perrier does, because the fact that now that Perrier is a potential for people to know what studio to look out for now in terms of leaks, because that they'll start taking notes on what animators are working for who. So it's gonna be really interesting to see what we get. And also, I guess I should bring up Anime Japan too. Of course, we had the pre-introduction to Anime Japan and we had the lineup. However, what I've just recently learned today, that actually the stuff for Anime Japan hasn't actually all been announced yet, and there's a few studios. Perrier aren't at Anime Japan, however TV Tokyo is. So, and I don't think Perrier were at the last one or the one before that either, and it was just TV Tokyo that was making the announcements. So it is going to be very interesting to see if Bleach does get a booth. I'm not going to hold my breath on it, because again, it's the coronavirus and things are different. So obviously it's now fully online. So the old methods of how, you know, people would pre-know about booths in advance has kind of changed a little. So we're going to have to wait and see if Bleach is going to be at Anime Japan. So again, I think we should start hearing some things soon and the tables should start rolling. So I just wanted to give my quick thoughts. What are your guys' thoughts? Of course, in the comment section down below, do you think it is Perrier? Why do you think it's Perrier? And are you excited? Do you think Perrier can redeem itself if it is? With that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Been Hansened. And as always, people, peace out.